Jace Wreck. Does anyone know where the Tinajas Atlas is? You? No?
That nice welt, I don't think. Maybe we'll find another guy or gal that knows where it's at.
Holy smoke. Do you know which way that is to the tanks? Nobody seems to know out here. We're just roaming around out here. Can you help us? Oh, looky there. U.S. Border Patrol, baby. Jace Wreck. I tell you what, you know, you get pumped up to do this, and I'm not going to tell you that I don't, but I'm going to tell you one thing. I am so pumped up today. You know, this is an opportunity today. If you didn't know where we're at by the intro right there, I'm going to tell you. I'm standing right now on the Mesa of Death.
Yeah.
The road of the devil that I've wanted to come forever. We're going to go up to the 9 tanks. What we're hoping to do is go to all 9 tanks, but there's a petroglyph up here that's supposed to be probably the most important petroglyph in the state of Arizona. Wish me luck. I've got a clue from an old article of 1940, and you got here and there was no water. Well, guess what? You were probably gonna die. There were over 63 graves. We're so tired, they couldn't climb the 50 feet where water was and died right there. I heard it's gonna get a little hairy, so we'll see. The bleached bones of the people that died at this location. Everyone that was anyone in the Southwest came to this area. Wow, I can't wait to get up there. There's grinding holes and there's supposed to be a petroglyph that I've never seen photographed. So if we could find that today, if we could find that petroglyph, man, I'm telling you what, it would be one of those things that would probably be one of the biggest things that we have done as a channel, and me as an historian and an adventure seeker, have ever come across. And we're gonna head up there and we're gonna see how treacherous this really is, and that people would be dead at the bottom of this tank. They couldn't get in here. Got a first tank right here. I expected it to be a lot taller, a lot farther up than this right here. Somebody's left some goods there, and then the rest of it is just figuring out how we're gonna work our way through here. That's pretty steep. That's gonna be an interesting climb. It really is. A lot of times I'm gonna have to put you in a pocket, because if you see, that is a steep tank. Those are steep walls. We're gonna head that way. Well, I'm starting to huff and puff a little bit. There's why I came down. One thing I wanted to show you was this right here. Okay, that's a steel rod. They used to have cables. They used to come down this hill and used to be able to pull a cable. And we still got to go up there. And we're only at tank 1. You know, we got 1 tank down. And I'm telling you what, it ain't for the weak of heart. And it ain't for the ones afraid of heights, because we just got this started and there you are. This is why they died down here. This is why there were 63 bodies of men buried down here. And this is why the horses and the, you know, the sun-bleached bones were everywhere for this very reason. Now when you get up here and you talk about this stuff, you definitely get why it is what it is. We're heading right up there and then we'll see what we get. So if we look down there, we come across that point right there, and we are getting ready. Now it looks like that's number 3 down there. Kind of 2 pools, but I'm gonna say that that's 2. And then 3 will be on up. And here is first graffiti. Jay Duncan, April. I don't know if that's 93. That's the first I've seen of any graffiti. I'll tell you what, so far, you know, I'm not gonna say it's scary, but I'm also not gonna tell you that it's like super comfortable. So I'll tell you what, holding this camera, bringing you guys along is a hell of a lot of fun, but It's not always the most comfortable, to be honest with you. 2, 3. Now, what that means is between 3 and 4, somewhere in here is a crevice that should have a petroglyph we're looking for. But is that the better way? You know, none of them are comfortable. So, and then you think about, oh shit, I gotta get down. So climbing up is a hell of a lot easier than climbing down. I do see what looks like to be petroglyphs over there on those rocks that we're definitely gonna look at when we figure out the best way to climb down off of here. And we're gonna really start looking now. Okay, right down there, we're gonna go that's number 3. We're gonna kick through here. We're gonna try this valley and see if the valley is a little easier. Figure out why they died. Now we're gonna start really looking hard, because if that's 3, because we got mountain goat climbing up here. So, you know, all these crevices, these could definitely, that could be in any of these. But there's what we got. This is where we come from. This is where we're heading. That's just gonna be an interesting hike up that way. You know, just to let you guys know, here, looking down in here, and the thing is, I've got to get in here to see if I can find, because I'm told that kind of how I understood it was that the petroglyph was going to be on this wall, so, you know, wherever it was at. So it was going to be upside down on top, like on the ceiling. So, you know, if it had been easy, somebody else would have found it. But we're going to start trying to make sure that we really look at anywhere that they could have laid underneath and put that in there. But I'm sure right over this hill here is another tank. And so this is supposed to be in this area. Man, hope you're having fun, man. This is a whole nother level. This is another level. So I'm going to go up this ridge right here. I'm going to have to do it without you, or with you when you're at the top. I'll bring you back out. But I've got to get up this ridge and do it safe. Well, here we go. Here's tank number 4. Look down there. See the grinding holes on that rock down there? So they were setting up in here. I'm going to get you down in here. Grinding holes right there. Nice grinding hole. They did a lot of work up here. This looked pretty interesting, though, because it looked like it went back. So, wow, look at that. Still pretty deep. Wow, look at that over there. Big rock through there. So there's number 4 right here for sure. And I'm telling you, that looks like a glyph up there, but I can't tell. I'll be walking. I'm gonna make my way up that ridge. Really, there's really not any way I see to get over there. And you know, one thing that I've learned from others that have traveled this trail is you kind of want to remember your path, because once you get down, anytime you go down, you might have to go back up. But anytime you look out there, might have seen wagon trains, might have seen conquistadors, might have seen ancients walking. You know, this was a main trail for salt and seashells to the coast. So they would come in here and they would go out there and they would gather that stuff and then they would trade it. So we're gonna put you away. I'm gonna go up that ridge. Hopefully I'll chat with you when I get up there. Well, tank 5 is right there. We just came up that steep ass hill. So, you know, I've had a couple slips with my shoes, which are usually, I mean, pretty damn bulletproof. But definitely, it's a challenge. That's gonna be a journey. Let's get back up here and see what we got. It's gonna be a journey. And then you gotta shoot across that little top. I think it won't be bad coming down. You kind of get into this trough. So we're gonna do this smart. And it looks like number 6 is right there. Right over there, if I can just get across that top. Right there should be 6. So I should be looking at these caves too as I'm going up here. But that's a steep son of a gun right there. I'm telling you, I'm gonna do a little ass sliding. You gotta be jacked up. I'm planning on getting jacked up today. Yes, sir.
Everything okay? How are you?
I'm at 5 right now, and I think I can see 6, but man, you talk about straight up.
Be careful. Take your time.
Oh, yeah, you can't play up here. This is like, I'm getting ready to go up a ridge right now that's sheer strong. I mean, hell, it's damn near climbing, but, you know, I'm not going to, it looks like a safe path, so I'm not too concerned about it. It's going to be harder getting down than up.
Yeah, that's what they say. The way down is a dangerous one.
Yeah, because you can kind of pick your way down, and like I said, I've got some of these grooves, and I'm definitely gonna make a call when I see 6 to see what the rest of it looks like. And then, you know, I'm not gonna get in a situation where I'm not comfortable at all. But it's pretty unbelievable. This is definitely, if you wanted an adventure today, you got one. You know, as an explorer, you're always wanting to get to the goal, whatever the goal was. And there gets to be a point where you just go, I tried this rim up here, man, my shoes aren't holding. I tried this rim up here, and my shoes aren't holding. But the last thing I ever want to do, no shit, is let you guys down. Because I didn't climb all the way up here to say stop, but as you get to a point where you definitely know this ain't making no sense. And I feel really disappointed, man. It's kind of like I went up the 3 different ways because I'm like, man, the last thing I want to do is come up here and fail, regardless of any mission that we go on, whatever the journey or adventure is, right? But there's a point where you go, okay, there's my point where, you know, I had a worse time getting up wasn't as difficult, but then I'm like, okay, now you got to get down. So how's that going to be? And you're like, damn, wow. And you know, I've never ever gave up on an adventure yet. I have not. And you know what? I think I've come to the point where, you know, I'm not going to go higher than tank 5. You know, I just don't think it's smart at this point. And you know, a better man than I. And you know, the shoes, they're not holding like I wanted to hold. If you're going to come up here, man, make sure that your shoes, you got your new pair out. Because I'm telling you what, this was a difficult deal. Now, what we are going to do is we're going to go down and we're going to see if we still can't find the petroglyph. So I'm going to take this time that I would have spent trying to get to the top. And you know, could I have got up there? Yeah, but you know what? If you're doing this by yourself, man, you want somebody there with you if you're going to climb this. I mean, Aquachigger got to a point where up here, he also decided, you know what, I should listen to him. So Bo, sorry about that. But what a great adventure regardless. I'm not mad. I still got to get down. And, you know, it's not going to be easy even sliding down what I've came so far. But, wow, incredible journey, man. I'm not, you know, I've got to be smart because I want you to be smart. I want you to make good decisions when you do this stuff because, you know, last thing you want to do is slide down there and cause a lot of people a lot of problems because you got to know when to be not stupid enough to make sure that you get to go fight another day. And we're not done yet. We're going to the bottom. I'm going to try to find that petroglyph. That's the real reason why I came here. Yeah, did I want to get to the top? Hell yes, I did. And I'm super disappointed, but I'm also like, come on, Jeff, be smart about what you do. This is not time to be stupid. Man, a little blood today. Look at there. Look at that guy coming out of that hole. Look at him. Look at him. He's like, look at these guys. Looks like a Chuck Waller from here. Look at him. It's crazy. Man, I wish I'd have found. I'm disappointed about the climb, but I'm not heartbroken. Well, you know what? I think we've done what we can do. We're still gonna skirt around the mountain. You know, here's what I've got to go now, but here's what's so funny is when you spend enough time up here, what happens is, man, you just get used to it. I can't hardly even explain it, but you know, it's not even a big deal. So you got to get through that initial, you know, coming down phase, but it doesn't even bother me now, which is kind of crazy. We're going to walk down around here. But you know, after you bend that stuff on the top, this stuff really doesn't even come close to freaking you out anymore. Look at that rock. That's crazy looking. That'd be a good place for a petroglyph if I can get down. I know I can get down. Can I get up? If you're lucky, that's all you have to do. Is that right there? Definitely do not want to fall down in that one. That's a bad one. There's number one. So, the only thing is, I want to see if there's anything over there. Looks like this is the trail, actually. They will wear these rocks out through years by working the trail, and you can actually see it. So we're gonna work our way down here, and if we gotta work out, that's fine. But this would be a great place to have put petroglyphs right here. This would be the place. If I was gonna see a place where there would be petroglyphs. But as we look into it, there's something right there. But I don't see. This kind of, even though it doesn't fit the now this kind of fits my MO on what I think it should look like. You know, so what's kind of funny is I gotta take my sunglasses off. I gotta make sure I don't see where is my, okay. Holy shit. Huh. Man, I think I found it. Holy shit. Man, I can't. It's not real. Oh, my God. You got to be kidding me. Oh. Wow. That's got to be it right there. That has got to be it right there. Oh my God, I never thought in a million years that I would find this thing, but that definitely, I mean, there's the sun. And you know, the guy said it was 50. He said it was 50. I don't know, man, it looks like it might have been blue. Oh my God. Okay, look where we're at. You know, they said that it was, oh man, that's got it. Oh man, oh gosh dang, oh, wow. Oh, I mean, it's not as clear, but that definitely, that's got the pattern of a sun right there. Now that kind of looks like, it looks like it used to be blue. So maybe, I don't know if that's it. And It looks like it's been pecked too, as well. You know, and he said it was about 50 feet from the edge of a cliff, but they stated it was not where it's at. If that is it. Okay, now if you look over here, some more pictogramphs right there. There's a line, and then there's more here on the ceiling. Now, I think some of the red might be that also. But if you look up there, I'm gonna get you guys really up on this, if I can. I gotta get way back in this hole. This is crazy. This is crazy. I'm so stoked. I can't even believe it. There, but I'm telling you what, we're gonna slide out of here. And I hope you can see that. It's gonna be difficult, but I can tell that is what it is. I can tell that is the blue petroglyph that we were looking for. That is it. I die. Look at that. I can't even tell what they are. I just know they're there. Oh, maybe that, is that the sun? There's markings all over that. Look at that. Oh man, that's crazy. Oh man. Let's work our way out of here. Come over here and then just walk down. Thousands of ancients, Spaniards, pioneers, natives traveled to get to that most precious commodity, water. How unreal is that? So you just saw me drop. Wow, that hurt. Man, that hurt. So look, I got all the way down that hill and I got to the last 6 feet right here. It fell. Chewed up my hand. Felt like I broke my finger, but I don't think it's broke. But just goes to show you, I mean, you can't ever go to sleep up here. Look at this, just this flat rock out here. You know, look at this thing. Kind of shape of an arrowhead too, but look at all those spots. So you can just imagine they were down here. A lot of modern graffiti up in here, which is pathetic, but it is what it is. You know, you might notice that I'm leaving the trail with a few more items than I left the trail with, but you know what? Clean the areas up, man. If there's somebody left something there, you know, be the good Samaritan. Let's not leave rubbish in any of these places. There's no need for it. And, you know, haul it down. That's all at least we can do to take care of these places. Definitely make sure that you, if you see trash, take the trash home, man. Nothing worse than having these places trashed up, especially in Arizona. We don't need that. So, I mean, you don't need it anywhere. So, what a great day, man. I'm telling you what, I'm so stoked. We, you know, didn't get as far up as I wanted. I tell you what's funny now, I'd be more comfortable doing it. So if you're gonna do this, you know, give yourself an hour or so on the bottom, just working it, and just get used to it. And then once you get used to it, it ain't really a big deal. It's just that initial getting used to it, this kind of, a little weird, but you know, just give yourself some time. And what a beautiful day, what a gorgeous place. I mean, just take a look at this. I mean, my gosh, what, how better of a day it is than that, you know? And to be where the ancients were and the Spanish were, doesn't get any better than that. The pioneers, What a crazy great day. Glad you could come along. Please like, please subscribe. Please hit the notification bell and put all. So every time that we have an adventure, you come along with us. So, man, it don't get any better than this. Man, look at this. 360. Jay Shrek. Black Flag Expedition, another one in the books. Got what we wanted.